going to show today is the power consumption of the different components of this Model 1 Radio Shack TRS-80. The original purchase was 1978, and that just consisted of the keyboard down here and the monitor and a cassette player, which I don't have right now. Now, the power consumption totally, I'm just going to show you right there. We're at 0 watts. So I'm going to now start turning the different components on. Just to let you know that I do leave the expansion interface button pushed in, so this is on all the time, and I turn it on and off by this. So I heard a click. That's the relay in here clicking on. Then get the monitor warmed up, and there's a switch behind the floppy drive here. So they're on, and then the next thing is there's a power button for the CPU. And now you'll see this display, which is normal. There's no disk in here. When you have a floppy drive, this is what comes up, and that is normal, so that's good. So now let's take a look at what the power consumption is currently at with all these components on. And I'm seeing 52.8 watts. All right, now I'm going to shut it off again here and then do each of the different components just to see what they add up to now. So here I'm just going to shut the monitor off, floppy drive off. Actually, I should turn this off. Also, and then this guy off, monitor off, which it is, and then I turn this off, and that just shuts the expansion interface off. All right, here you can see the monitor flashing in the background, so that's all that's on. I unplugged everything else in the power strip and the line filter, and you can see that's 17.4 watts. Alright, now on to the expansion interface. Now I have it set up, and you're going to see right here, I'm reading about 2.9 watts. Getting there a little closer. And what that's really from is, there's these power supplies that goes to the expansion interface that's inside. This is the one for the CPU, but there's another one that's inside. And that one I cut open, so that's why there's a rubber band around it. I was just looking what's inside there. I thought it was bad, but it wasn't. Okay, now I'm going to turn on the expansion interface here. That's this button right here. Push it in. Okay, it clicked. Now let's take a look at what the additional power consumption is. So, maybe about 4 watts is what that's running about right in there. Okay, now I'm going to, that's it, sorry, I mean this is, right here says 7.2 watts, but then you got to subtract 3 from that, so roughly about 4 watts is what the expansion interface is consuming. Right here I don't have the CPU on yet, but it's the same thing. I do have 3.2 watts, which again is that power supply right there that's consuming that. So I'm now going to turn on the CPU. Let's see what the additional is. And I'm looking at 10.6 watts. Okay, and then the last thing I'm going to do is the floppy drive. Alright, now I have the floppy drive hooked up. And it's reading 0. Then I'm going to go back there and turn it on. And then see what I got now. 16.7 watts. Alright, now here I'm going to just turn on the different devices. The first one is going to be, oh, let me do 2 down on here to put it in watts mode. I'm going to turn on the line. Well, I guess what I should show first is I'm at 0 right now. Alright, now I'm going to turn on the line filter. And I'm reading about 6.1 watts, which is really each one of these power supplies that are on is taking about 3 watts each. And there's 2 of them, one for the CPU and one for the expansion interface. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is push the button there on the expansion interface. click. And we were at 6, now what are we up to? Alright, now we're up to 10.4 watts. The next thing I'm going to do is click on the monitor there. On top. Alright, and now coming back, let's see what we're at now. That takes a little bit, 27.3 watts. Not bad though. 27.6, 5. Alright. Now I'm going to turn on the floppy drive. And let's see what we got here. 44.2, 44. And then last, I'm going to just turn on the CPU. And let me see what we're at now, about 52.1 watts. Alright, so we're about 52, and now I'm going to put in a floppy disk. Get this cleared out of here a bit. Get these wires out of the way. So I can get this door open. I'm going to put in a game again, this game here. I don't know if you can see the internet. Defense command. Needs about 32K of memory. And then just see what, while it's loading, how much additional power is taken by the floppy drive. So then I'm going to go over here, hit the reset button. Alright, kind of see it loading the game, and what are we at there? Yeah, it takes a little bit more, 61 watts, so 6, maybe 7 watts more, and then when it's done, it's back to 54, or 51, even a little bit less. 51, and the game is flashing there. Okay, in this setup, I'm going to have a line printer 2. Which is this guy right here. It's kind of nice, it's a dot matrix, and it surprisingly still works after 40 years. Kind of see it there. I did some prints already, you can kind of see the program I'm just printing out right now. So what I'm going to do here is see where we're at. With this setup, I'm about 56.9 watts, and then I'm going to, that's with the printer on right now. And then I'm going to set it up to print a few characters and see what it starts at here. Alright, you can kind of see right there, I'm just going to print those lines. Let's see, what is it, 10250 to 10347 on this program here. And just going out here ways. And then I'm just going to hit the enter key. And actually, what I'm going to do before I hit the enter key, I'm going to focus on what the watts is. Okay, it's 56.7 watts, and now I'm going to hit the enter key. And jumps down a little bit up to 71 watts. And you can kind of see it. I guess it just finished there. And that's what it printed out. So not too much more either. I mean, with this whole setup and even with the line printer, I got 71 watts was the peak, so not a very, pretty good. I mean, it doesn't really draw a lot of current, so, and power. All right, well, I just wanted to share that, and thanks for watching.